NASA addresses the coronavirus pandemic, some online material to stay connected with NASA, and more testing with our Orion spacecraft. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. NASA Administrator Jim Bridenstine addressed the coronavirus pandemic in a statement saying, "The protection and care of the NASA family is the top priority. As a cautionary measure and with several confirmed cases of the illness reported around the agency, NASA instituted a mandatory telework policy for all employees on March 17th, with the exception of those needed to maintain continuity of mission essential activities." The administrator added in the statement that NASA is working closely with the White House Coronavirus Task Force and other U.S. government agencies in a unified response to coronavirus. With many of us staying close to home right now, a reminder that there is a wealth of online NASA material available if you'd like to stay connected with the agency and its mission. In case you missed it, the fourth season of the NASA Explorers video series is now available in its entirety on the NASA Explorers Facebook and NASA's YouTube accounts. Season 4 follows a team of scientists through the process of conducting an experiment aboard the International Space Station. Many ebook titles are also available online, including a series of International Space Station guides to help potential researchers learn how their ground-based experiments can be translated to the space environment. Hubble Focus is another notable series of ebooks. The series takes a deep dive into the specific fields of astronomy that have been forever changed by our Hubble Space Telescope. April 24th will mark the 30th anniversary of Hubble's launch. Our Orion spacecraft has completed its three-month test campaign at NASA's Plum Brook Station in Sandusky, Ohio. The testing subjected Orion to the extreme temperatures and electromagnetic environment it will experience during Artemis 1, the spacecraft's upcoming uncrewed test mission to the Moon. With this round of testing complete, Orion will be returned to our Kennedy Space Center in Florida, where it will begin preparations for launch. NASA's landing and recovery team practiced securing a test version of Orion into the well deck of a Navy ship this past week. The team worked to validate recovery procedure timelines as NASA plans to send Orion around the Moon on Artemis 1 and safely recover the spacecraft after splashdown in the Pacific Ocean. Former NASA astronaut Al Worden passed away March 18th in Texas. As the command module pilot on Apollo 15, he stayed in lunar orbit while Dave Scott and Jim Irwin conducted surface exploration on the Moon. The mission was the first to use the lunar roving vehicle. During the flight back from the Moon, Worden became the first human to carry out a deep space EVA or spacewalk. Altogether, Worden logged more than 295 hours in space. Al Worden was 88 years old. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.